The creation of music exists in a dream space. It's not tied to reality. It's more freeing and the possibilities become endless. I try and stay in that zone as long as possible.
Það er hægt að við bara komið niður til núna og bara svona skoðu aðeins.
Já, já, ekkert mál.
Ekkert mál, ok. Verður þú á staðinn, að?
Já, já, ég hérna.
Ok, ég kem að spjalla við þig.
Þú bara.
Ok.
Well, you definitely got some very Icelandic weather, that's for sure. Contemporary film composition is largely a process of the film being delivered to the composer. More or less a finished object. 1899 and my working relationship with it is nothing like that. I'm writing based on an idea as opposed to an edit. While costumes are being designed and sets are being built, I'm also writing. It is a much more meaty role to kind of get involved early and work off the scripts. Everybody's kind of starting in the same place. They sort of all, we all fan out and go off on our own adventure.
Góðan daginn. Er Bjössi uppi það? Væri það allt í lagi að bara svona vaða
1899 is the story of a migrant ship moving from the old world to the new world and all of the weirdness that kind of occurs along the way. More than that though, I think what the story is about for me is relationships and how they transcend time and space and even reality. '1899 was recorded all over the world. The Tangram Ensemble from London, traditional Chinese percussion ensemble. Recordings from Krakow, the Sinfonietta Cracovia, this amazing string section, the same people I worked with on Dark. And then there's actually quite a lot of vocal material as well. I worked with a range of different vocalists. It was about sort of trying to approach the score in such a way that there wasn't a lot of logic involved in terms of what would fit with what. I mean, Greek folk singer, Polish orchestra, Chinese percussion. I knew that by kind of going down that road, I'd end up somewhere new and weird. It really is a truly unique kind of reflection of a lot of the ideas that are at the heart of the show. The real darkness is in a lack of control. In a musical way, where that starts to manifest itself is where I purposely make situations where I'm not in control of what's happening. I took a lot of that material with me here back to Iceland and took it into various ships down here in the harbor, got access to the inside of these fishing vessels which are being repaired. So I'm taking those recordings and actually feeding them through a speaker into various parts of the ship and using the music to resonate, literally resonate the hull of the boat. It becomes something else, it becomes very alive.
Kind of terrifying, honestly.
My my role as a composer is ultimately that of being a storyteller amongst other storytellers. It's a really complicated narrative with a lot of different threads. A big part of my job is to sort of maybe speak the truth when other elements within the filmmaking are taking you down a different path. The fabrication of the reality around our main cast, even this idea that some of these people would keep reappearing on a loop, essentially. That really stuck with me as an idea to take the score and to mess with it temporarily in making loops, taking pieces of analog tape which have the score recorded on them, actually cutting them into looping pieces of tape so that they would have this dislocating, fracturing element to them where it almost feels like they're restarting. This strange consciousness that the music that you're hearing is being played back. The music itself is part of this mechanism, of this fabrication. There's a lot of trust there, which I'm extremely grateful for. Ultimately, the effect of that is, I think for me as an artist, is it makes me want to push further. I push things way, way further.